Hey everyone, Forrest here with Rocky Mountain School of Photography. Come along with me as we travel across the country to photograph the solar eclipse. Let's do it. Hey everybody, so just flew into Memphis, Tennessee, and now I'm driving to Hot Springs, Arkansas, which is where the totality is actually gonna happen. And we're gonna be part of the Ecliptic Festival, which is part of an Atlas Obscura event. Atlas Obscura is kind of like a tour group, kind of a cool little crew. And they are doing an ecliptic event for the eclipse with music and presentations, and B&H is gonna be part of that. And we're gonna be running telescopes for the participants of that event. So it should be pretty fun.
We have Skywatcher scopes, Celestron scopes, we have some from ZWO, we have some ZWO cameras, a lot of cool pieces of gear that all need to get set up. So that's kind of my mission, is to go over there this morning. We're going to be working pretty much through the day to get those all running, operational, aligned, and everything ready, so that tomorrow during the evening there's a star party, and tomorrow during the day people can check out the sun. So let's go ahead and do it.
This is the road into the park. Cedar Glade Park. So pretty. So behind me we can see we got the tents back there, two little tent areas, and then spinning around back here, that's the B&H tent where we're gonna have the scopes going, and then we've got one kind of main stage right there, and there's another one over down behind some trees that way. So over here in the B&H tent we got some smart scopes, some bunch of Celestron stuff, bunch of kit pieces, so it should be pretty awesome. Get all this stuff going today. So I just got scope number one set up. Here we've got a little Skywatcher 82 millimeter refractor with a ZWO 2600 MC Pro, little ZWO ASI Air, and then that's all powered by a little Goal Zero power bank. So we got most of the scopes set up. Couple issues with a couple of them, but everything is working. So day one today was mostly just getting everything set, testing. No one's looking through them yet, but tomorrow we actually have scheduled scope look through time. So that's gonna be where people are actually coming over to check stuff out and kind of see what we got going. All right, it's the evening of night number one. Hopefully you guys can hear me all right, but I wanna show you guys the scopes that we have set up. So this is gonna be our visual setup. We've got a Celestron Nexstar 6 with a big old, I think this is a 32 millimeter eyepiece. 35 mil. And then here we've got the big ticket item, 82 millimeter scope with a 2600. This background music is awesome. So here we are, the evening of night number two. We can see all the scopes set up behind us. We actually have a lecturer coming to talk about some of the objects in the sky here in a couple hours. And then we're from 11 to midnight just looking at the stars. So I've got my rig set up over there as well. I'm gonna be doing a little bit of stuff. We've got a photographer as well who's gonna be doing some light painting portraits, a lot of cool things planned. All right, it is night three. Tomorrow is the big day, and we are getting the scope set for our final night of star partying. We've got the B&H team back there. We're setting up a few scopes. We're gonna have them pointing at M3, the Orion Nebula, the Leo Triplet. Let's see what else. Jupiter's up for a little bit. Should be a good time. So last night we had quite the crew. Tonight we're hoping to have even more people because there's more people in the festival. So should be great. Well, today is the big day. We are heading in back to Cedar Glades Park to shoot the eclipse. It's about 9:30 in the morning, so we've got about 3 hours before the first contact starts. I did a little bit of a stress test yesterday, making sure that everything was functioning the way that it should, and it all worked well. So I think we're in good shape for eclipse day. What I'll do is I'll kind of show you guys some footage from this. I'm gonna get everything set, and I'll catch you guys once things are set, walk you through the rig, and we should be good to go.
All right, everybody, I just got the rig set up. We are about an hour and a half from first contact, so there's quite the crowd gathering around for photography purposes. Seems like the B&H tent is a hit for that. So we are just kind of getting everything tested, making sure trackers are working, checking the gear. We've got a William Optics 250mm scope here, the Space Cat or Red Cat 51, EOS RA on the back, little Fuji X-T4 with a 35mm lens, and then it's all being tracked on a Skywatcher Star Adventure GTI. I've also got an intervalometer with a dual splitter, so I can fire both cameras with the same intervalometer, and then a USB power bank running the tracker throughout the day. You guys can see quite a number of other photographers. B&H has the scope set up, filters, all kinds of exciting things.
But we also have on a digital scope,
we are 10 minutes out from second contact right now, getting ready. The light has turned this really magical silver color. It's still hard light, but it's got like an interesting color hue to it. So we need to have a little talk. You guys, here's the deal. I think that eclipses get a lot of undue media attention. I think the media blows out of proportion eclipses because obviously they should. It's clickbait, right? You get more views. Here's the deal. If you've never been to an eclipse at totality, and I mean in the path of totality, not 98%, not 99%, 100%, you need to put it on your list of things to do in your life. It is absolutely one of the most amazing, breathtaking, life-changing experiences you can ever do. I mean, it truly is. Ideally, share it with people. Go to an eclipse in a way where you're around other people, because honestly, that's half the fun of it, is seeing how other people react to it, hearing the gasps of the crowd, getting the goosebumps. It's amazing. And if you've been in a 90% region and you think you've seen an eclipse, you really haven't. It's truly not that way. So here's the deal. I agree, the media blows some of this stuff out of proportion, but I also think it should be a bucket list item for everyone in the world to at least experience totality in an eclipse at some point. This is an amazing trip. Eclipse number 2 in the books. I'm definitely gonna do more of them because boy, it's a fun experience. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something. I hope you got a little bit of entertainment out of it following along on this epic journey. And I hope you guys subscribe for more. Leave a like down below. Ask me any questions down in the comment section. And I'll see you in a future video. Thanks, everybody.